Can I make a hard switch to domestic British politics? Your brother Ed Miliband.
But I will. You can make a hard switch, but I will do a very statesmanlike demurral, probably.
All right. Well, let's see. Your brother Ed Miliband led your party to its worst defeat in around 30 years, and now, as you know, there's a full-scale leadership contest underway to replace him. Where do you stand in this contest? I assume you're not going to give me names, but should this be more of the sort of left-leaning, sort of socialist unionist kind of candidate, or should it be more in the Blairite modernising centrist candidate?
Well, my answer to where I stand in this leadership question is a very simple one. I'm running an international humanitarian organization in New York, so I'm obviously not a candidate in this leadership election. What I think is important for all the candidates is to reflect on the very clear lessons of two devastating electoral defeats for the Labour Party in the last 5 years, which have come for a very clear reason. And the reason is that the public have concluded that instead of building on the strengths and remedying the weaknesses of the Blair years, the party has turned the page backwards rather than turning the page forwards. And so I think it's the responsibility of all the candidates to find again that combination of economic dynamism and social justice that defined the success of the Labour Party in the 1990s and the early 2000s, but also the success of Democratic parties in the US, of centre-left parties in Europe as well. And the responsibilities on those in politics now in the Labour Party are very real, because the details of the election defeat that Labour suffered are very sobering indeed.
Do you think the party is fully cognizant, in other words, as they are hammering out this leadership contest and what they should do in the future, does it look like a party who realises that they've actually suffered a stunning defeat?
I think there's a profound sense of shock and disappointment in Labour ranks. Obviously, Labour is in power in the great cities of Northern England, and those local government leaders are making their voice heard to a national party that needs to catch up with the way Britain has changed, the way politics has changed, and the kind of agenda that needs to be set in an age of economic insecurity, which is what exists across Europe at the moment.
There's a huge debate here about Europe, obviously, and how best to conduct a pro or anti-Europe campaign. Most leaders would say pro-Europe campaign. The Labour Party seems to be struggling between whether to support a nationwide, obviously government-led, yes campaign, or to go it alone and have just a Labour pro-Europe campaign. What would you suggest?
Well, I think it's very, very important indeed that the Labour Party maintains its principled as well as practical position, which is that even the talk of Britain leaving the European Union is dangerous for Britain, and the reality would be disastrous for Britain. So I think the most important thing is that the opposition party is constructively engaged. Now, I haven't followed the ins and outs of a debate that you're referring to about the organisation of the campaign for Britain to remain in the European Union when the referendum comes. It obviously will now come, given that there's a majority Conservative government conducting a renegotiation campaign. But the absolutely vital point is that the economic, the political, the international reasons for Britain to remain an absolutely key part of the European Union are put front and center. Sitting in New York, it's completely evident to me that no American government would ever take seriously a Britain that has withdrawn from the European Union. It's almost like Britain would be resigning from the world. And I think that in an age when the world is getting smaller, the kind of connections that the European Union represents are absolutely vital for medium-sized countries like the UK. And I very much hope and believe that the Labour Party will put itself at the forefront of that campaign.